Tarakeha, rākau tapu, te ramaroa, whakataha, ngā maunga. Tūmoana, ngā huia, pāte aroha, tauwhara, ngā marae. Tau Māori, ngai tūpoto, te hekutu, ngai tāwake, ngā hapū. Moitangi, tapu ai, whirinaki, waitangi, ngā awa. Hokianga ki tau mārere ahau, ti hei wā Māori. Kia ora, my name is Reva Mendes, and I come from a beautiful place in the far north of Aotearoa, New Zealand, called Hokianga. I am tangata whenua, indigenous to this land of Māori whakapapa genealogy, connecting me to not only the country but also to the Pacific. I am descended from both sides of the Hokianga harbour, north and south of the west coast, and have lived both sides as well. Our local hapū sub-tribes are many, of which I am affiliated to through both my parents, including the biggest tribe, Ngā Puhi, and also Te Rārawa. I live in a little town called Rawene, which is in the South Hokianga and has a population of about 6,000 to 7,000 people, of whom 60% are of Māori descent. It is a picturesque village on a peninsula jutting into the Hokianga harbour about halfway up the harbour. It is known as the town where the sun both rises and sets. I both work and live within my community of Rawene as a coordinator with another creative colleague, Kara Dodson, and we started up Ako Hokianga Arts and IT to help re-engage and develop within our Hokianga communities. I also work in between with my practice of raranga weaving, of harakeke and other natural fibres, as well as visual arts mixed media. I love integrating my time and experience within community education and development, and work within local trusts to help support the needs of Hokianga, which there are many. Low economic society, insufficient housing, and the cost of living is high, as well as the dependencies of alcohol and substances. I am also involved within my own local hapū and iwi as well, when needed to help support whānau, family, wānanga, workshops, seminars, and just being part of the whole whānau dynamics. Moi moia. I had a dream recently, and I believe it was divine timing that led me to being a part of presenting today. My expression of how I was feeling during my dream was very exciting and enlightening. I was describing feelings of all my senses combining and weaving together into something new, but still an acknowledgement of traditional knowledge and wisdom, bringing it forth into the unknown. My poem is of a moi moia, a dream, emerging from a deep desire within, a love and appreciation for the most amazing taonga, fibre and plant, kōrari harakeke. I awoke with a deep sense of taonga tuku iho, gifts and knowledge passed down through whakapapa in support of building a new way of being, and an environmental, cultural, sustainable and economical approach to a wide spectrum of solutions that enrich my whānau and community. A tōna wā. Kōrari, reach up to the sky, and leaves, wide and strong, yet flexible, sway in the wind, and I wonder. Shimmering light ahead, drawing me into a doorway to something beyond. Bright light illuminating, hands and arms lit up, body enlightened, organic warmth. Silk kisses the skin, floor, ceiling and walls radiating light. Beating as one, heart and soul, oxygenated, comforted, nurtured, a whare woven with love. Kōrari harakeke, calling to make, to create, to live and sustain, the journey unfolds. Past, present and future. Waka wairua raranga. This piece was made in acknowledgement of passing away. It's a traditional waka te papaku, which is a vessel or container or a basket that envelops and holds those that have passed on. And this one was made specifically for my niece's baby, who was born stillborn. And so I was very, I had a lot of aroha while I was making this. Yeah, it was very spiritual, my connection to making this for my niece's baby. In connection with the harakeke, it's all about whānau. You know, so it's like a full circle coming back around, you know, from the time you're born to the time you die, when you pass over, and to be able to help, support and give back in this way, and acknowledge and be able to preserve our tikanga and our culture and our practices. So this is an educational poster which I've used a lot of times in my workshops. So it gives good background on the past, on what the different varieties of harakeke are, the different uses for clothing, baskets, mats, ropes, sails, medicine, paper, the significance of conservation and preserving kaitiakitanga, looking after our planting to preserve our heritage. The harakeke educational poster was from National Geographic magazine. And the photo on the right was taken from the Foxton Flax Mill in 2022. A part of my practice is to be able to educate and pass on our conservation practices and tikanga associated to harakeke kōrari. We have so many uses and in the past, we've had our traditional Māori practices, and then we've also had different flax industries that were booming from 1899 to 1919, after the World War I. From 1920s on, many changes happened, and hand labour was replaced by machinery within the flax industry. And now there are a lot more modern machinery and technologies towards innovation. For example, cosmetics, bioplastics, fibre and textiles. Kiwi Fibre are high-tech innovators who use harakeke to develop natural fibre composites, replacing fibreglass and carbon fibre. Future fibres and e-textile works, research and progress. Thanks to Awhi World, Whangarei, and Awhi Incubator, I have had the opportunity to be a part of this symposium, which has been very supportive in allowing my own individual practice to come to light. Future possibilities. I endeavour to create my own strategic harakeke plan, locally made Hokianga harakeke paper and workshops. This image is of a portable Hollander beater created by Mark Lander and is used throughout the country and abroad to create the most amazing natural organic paper. This will help me to engage with our local communities in support of using our local organic natural resource. So the next steps are looking at the different community-based models, how they run, are they a social enterprise, a community enterprise, exploring different business models and enterprises. What more is there to find out? Ideas and solutions, future funding for further workshops, collaborative approaches, Indigenous Māori-led practitioners and local hapū and iwi. Harakeke is such an important fibre and resource, and there's so many benefits and possibilities that can be utilised within our local community in the Hokianga. And it would support us in so many ways if we could find an industry that would be able to provide income, support families, and further growth within our communities. I want to have my dream of a harakeke-filled world, an alternative reality garden, come true.